how would you explain feminism in society today?
Sure. Well, jazakallahu khairan for having faith in my ability to do so. I will do my best. It's not always easy to explain because this is such a dense and complex topic. The reality is that there is no one agreed upon definition of feminism, even among feminists themselves. Depending on which feminist you're talking to, they will give you their, you know, taste of what feminism means to them. And in large part, that's because there have been different waves of feminism throughout the last century. But the sort of generally agreed upon broad statement is that it is the movement for equal rights for women. That is the most, you know, generally agreed upon definition that I have found. Okay, so the first thing that I want us to understand is that we're going to talk about feminism based on the definition that we just agreed upon, that it is a movement to get equal rights for women. Okay? Now, we cannot take these words for granted. We cannot assume that we have the same understanding of what equal rights is. We can't even agree that women's rights is what we should be seeking in the first place. Because according to feminism in the Western world, the UK, the US, Canada, and other first world countries, women's rights means women being able to do whatever men do.
Mm-hmm.
Women's rights in Islam does not mesh with this definition. Okay, the way that God has decreed for women to attain their rights and what those rights are very different from what the West tells us is women's rights. And I'll be going back and forth between saying the West and the secular paradigm. And paradigm here just means worldview, the framework, the way that we perceive the world and what morality is and what immorality is. So the moment we begin to engage with this definition of feminism, we have agreed to adopt wholesale its history, its language, its terms, its definitions, its values, what it deems to be moral and what it deems immoral. And what we find is that oftentimes those sets of values they're not compatible with what Islam tells us our values should be. Does that make sense so far?
Yes. So what you're saying is that feminism, it's basically a godless idea. Yeah, it's not based on belief in God. So therefore, straight away, it's got a different foundation to Islam. So therefore, but we do need to understand what are the roots of feminism?
Yes, I'm saying that to an extent. So not every wave of feminism, I wouldn't say every wave of feminism was godless in its most superficial sense, because certainly first wave feminists would say that they are practicing Christians.
Oh, okay.
But for our purposes today, where feminism looks more intersectional, and we can talk about what that means in a moment, and it is often conflated with the LGBTQ movement, you almost cannot separate feminism from that social justice movement.
Mm-hmm.
Then I think you could more easily make the argument that feminism does not answer to a higher power or a higher authority.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. So one of the reasons why it doesn't make sense to call ourselves feminists as Muslims is because if you study the history of feminism and you study the works of Muslim women who identify as feminists, you see that they themselves are pointing out the incompatibility. And I'm trying not to get into mentioning specific names here, but many of the prominent Muslim feminists out there advocate for the rejection of hadith. They advocate for the rewriting or reinterpretation of the Quran. And so in that way, you're not actually proving that Islam and feminism are compatible. What you're saying is that they're incompatible. And what we need to do is we need to reform Islam.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Right? So that's the bottom line. That's the main problem right there.